Ms. Archana Jain, she is the HOD of this department. I would like to request Archana ma'am to please give the glimpse of this specialization. They are offering two specializations. Over to you, ma'am. Archana.
Thank you, Roshni, for the invite. Like Roshni said, I'm from the Department of Human Development. I'm the head of the department. And I'm offering, the department is offering two specializations. I'll be talking about them one after the other. The first specialization is early childhood care and education. Now, if you will go into the market or if you go to colleges, you will find lots of courses on early childhood care and education. So why this? Okay, the first thing that I want to share or I want to highlight is that this is not a diploma, it's a degree course. So when you do a degree in any specialization or any topic, it allows you better professional opportunities, and you know you can get better pay. If you do a diploma, okay, the chances of you getting exploited financially in the long run are higher, and we can't be doing the same thing always. So we start at an early age, you start with a career, and then you want to keep on reinventing yourself. So if you want to keep on reinventing, you want to keep on progressing, you want to keep on moving forward, you want to do diverse things, then you should be doing a degree in early childhood care and education. And if you are talking about why SVT, because SVT is the only autonomous college, well-established autonomous college, which has the freedom to design its courses as per the demands and the requirements of the market or of the profession in which you are choosing. So we have that freedom, and we have been reinventing with very, very creative courses which will keep you ahead of the market as opposed to just managing with that. So with that very brief introduction to early childhood care and education, I would request Roshni to move to the next slide. Now, like I said, that when you take up any career, the most important thing is what are you going to become at the end of the career? So over here, if you will see, okay, you're not just going to be a preschool teacher. Okay? That to any CE course will be able to make you do. But after you have done, you start even as a preschool teacher, you're not going to be wanting to be doing that for your entire life. So from being a preschool teacher, you could get into a supervisor role as a preschool teacher, or you could start your own school, early childhood care and education school. You could also move into creche and daycare centers, which is really in demand today, because with more and more women working, parents are willing to pay any amount to get a good care giving service for their children. So you can become someone who owns a creche or a daycare center. You can employ people under you, and you can run a good program so that more and more people come. Today, we know we are at a point where we have daycare facilities everywhere. Even if you go to the airport, there is a daycare facility. And you know something, that our girls are getting employed even over there in centers which are child care centers or creches at these various places. Other than that, you can also go into your own, starting your own ventures. So you can become an entrepreneur in terms of designing programs for children and do your own business, so you can work at your own time and will. You can also get into conducting language and creative classes and grooming the overall personality. So besides being an early childhood educator, someone who teaches children in a school, these are the things that you could do by yourself. And as a matter of fact, today, if you go, if you look at vacations, you will see there are so many summer camps and so many events that are being organized for children. You can be designing those events. Okay. So for example, if you know, if it's a birthday party and a parent wants to celebrate a birthday party, okay, you would be, a pro. You can do everything. You can do the games, you can do the puppet. That's because you're going to get trained in it. So going forward in the near future, after being a preschool teacher, if you want to have more opportunities, depending on where you are, which part of the world you are, what kind of responsibilities you want, okay, you can do this also. So these are the career, and even summer camps. Today, everyone is running after summer camps. So you could have your own summer camps and other events for children. You're going to get trained in this. So by the end of these 3 years, you'll be able to do this like very easily. Can we move to the next slide? Okay. So some of the skills that we are going to, of course, teach you is, of course, a good planning. So, you know, whenever we talk about teaching or working, we want good planning, very creative in preparing teaching aids and other material for children. So they are going to be taught those skills, promoting emotional growth. Today, emotions are so important when we talk about mental health, and you're going to be offered courses on this also. Now, another ECE programs, early childhood care and education programs do not look at mental health to an extent that we also offer counseling courses to the students who are doing early childhood education. So if you want to diverse from here to early childhood care, from early childhood to counseling, you can do that even with this course. Of course, with a special focus on infants and toddlers, which again is not something which is taught in every course. And that's another field, because today childcare facilities are really in demand. Along with this, we also, of course, develop skills of promoting overall development of the children. Like I told you, those personality classes. And you're also going to get opportunities to understand what children with special needs are. So if you want to go into special education, by the end of the 3 years, you can do that. Now, some of you may want to study further. Can you go to the next slide, Roshni? Some of you may want to study further, and some of you may want to be working immediately after the course. Both opportunities are available. These are some of the, you know, activities that our students engage in. So we are not only teaching in the class, you're going outside the class, you're going to schools, you're going to go to daycare centers, and you're really going to work with children to learn how to manage children and how to plan the program and how children react and how you should handle that. Can you go to the next slide? Okay, and the placements are many. I've just put three because they are renowned. One is the Tata Institute Fundamental Research. Many of our girls have got employment over there in their creche. There's a Learning Curve. This is the one where which has its daycare center at our airport, international airport. And then the other one is Children's Aid Society. So that's also very renowned. One of the students is working over there with these children and doing a fantastic job. These are just some examples. Other than that, of course, any preschool that you want to take up a job is an open opportunity for you. Immediately after your graduation, you will get a job and you will go on pay scale. So you are not compromised, and you get a good job. Okay, further education is of course possible. You, like I said, you could do your master's in early childhood education, human development, go into B.Ed, special education, or go into even technology. Okay, master's in educational technology. If you want to prepare online material for children, you're going to, that is also an opportunity. And we are of course going to be teaching a course in computer also over here. So that's about early childhood care and education. And these are the contact details of two of my staff. And we are going to have a webinar on this on Tuesday. I will share the details of that as I have your numbers. And you can attend the Tuesday program if you are interested in early childhood care and education.